Hey folks, and welcome to DevTrends. Today we're going to talk about Vue versus React GitHub battle, Airbnb sunset in React Native, and Node.js version 10.5 with multithreading support. So in the previous week there was a huge battle between React and Vue on GitHub. Some users noticed the first time Vue surpassed React in GitHub stars, and this event triggered the race in which developers were frantically starring both repositories to help each other to reach 100,000 stars first. And for the record, Vue won this race by a small margin of just a few stars. And there are even websites like Hubble.js on which you can see this ever-going race in real time. You can see Vue is leading still. Or another site, has Vue passed React yet? Search.sh, where you can check if Vue is ahead. And yes, it is, by the way. But does it really mean that Vue can be considered a better framework now? Of course not, because GitHub stars is not a quality indicator, but more a measurement of hype. Both frameworks have their strengths and weaknesses. The fact is, React is far more popular framework in terms of downloads and usage. As you can clearly see on NPM charts, React has like 10 times more downloads than Vue and keeps growing. And this also applies to infrastructure. For React, there is simply more advanced tooling and a lot of well-maintained libraries, and there are also great integrations for TypeScript and GraphQL. And in my experience, Vue still lacks a better support, at least for TypeScript, though it should change in the near future. But surely I like both Vue for being simple yet powerful, and React for all these advanced techniques and awesome possibilities it brought and keeps bringing to modern web. So there is no such thing as best framework in the world. We each choose our own tools, and we mustn't fall into arguing on them, but rather use these tools to build a better development world. By the way, framework developers themselves are supporting each other as well. Just look at this awesome cake sent to Evan Yu by React team. This is very adorable. Next news for today is about Airbnb and its experience with React Native. A set of articles has recently appeared on Medium that outline Airbnb's usage of popular application building platform. Airbnb first chose to use React Native back in 2016, but now it's saying goodbye to it. In its fourth article, they explain how they came to such decision. Airbnb says they faced different technical and organizational issues that they were unable to overcome and decided to stop this journey. React Native allowed developers to move faster in terms of code production, but lack of good debugging, for example, made things worse than it was on true native. So overall experience is considered to be mixed, though Airbnb team recognized that React Native framework is progressing very fast, and a lot of issues they faced in the beginning were addressed and fixed after. So Airbnb itself is a huge company which has all the resources to hire enough professional iOS and Android developers to build native apps on their own. And of course, if you have such possibilities, for most cases, it's better to develop an app on native tools like Swift for iOS or Java on Android. But React Native is an absolute winner in terms of overall effectiveness. With it, you can develop pretty decent native looking and feeling Android and iOS apps by yourself and using a single code base based on React and JavaScript without ever touching Java, Swift or C++. And this is truly great that we have such possibility now, and even though Airbnb chose another way, React Native community is only growing and Facebook actively pushes the development forward. Let's move to Node now. 10 is the latest LTS release number of Node.js, which means consistent updates and bug fixes and more than usual support timeline. Latest update number 10.5 brings a long-awaited support for native worker threads via module with the same name. Here is it, worker threads module. Worth noting that multithreading in Node.js existed for a long time via either, for example, child process or additional modules like web worker threads. And there is even full multithreaded Node.js runtime called Napa.js, developed by Microsoft. But these are kind of derivatives, and now we have truly native Node.js worker threads like we have in the browser. And they are still highly experimental and available under the flag, but the initial development is done, and this is just a matter of time when they are truly released. That's all for today, folks. All the links are in the description below. Thank you for watching and stay trendy.